How the skills require the workplace in different industries, and we have many industries represented here amongst the four of our panelists. How have these skills requirement in the workplaces evolved over the last, say, 10 to 15 years?
So as you see, between the 80s till now, the human interface has really gone. And to use the cliche, we moved from the industrial age to the information age, and now the digital age. And what does it tell us? It is essentially the dependence on the human being is getting to be more vital. And, you know, that famous quote of Mr. Murthy says, all my assets leave the office every evening and come back, right? Makes sense over here.
So I think that the skills requirement for every industry has evolved. But, you know, one can't really do a crystal ball gazing, but one has to really understand what is the requirement at that point in time and how is that industry really changing. And mold
sure. Build versus buy question, right? Which is really around, do we keep going out in the market or trying to source the talent which we need at different point of times in the evolution of an organization versus how much time, effort, energy should we be putting in to keep enabling and upskilling our own people as we continue to build the organization, right? So that's typically the question which I would like to pose to our panelists, which is build versus buy, what strategy works when it comes to enabling the organizations with the right talent?
I think both works. And now that build versus buy, to my mind, is passe. The new equation is build, buy, remake, and rent. That is the fourth element. So it's not only a choice between build versus buy, but there is a huge agenda of remaking. And that we are already experiencing. And in my opinion, this trend is likely to grow further. We will see in years ahead that the new age technology and application of the new technology will force the organizations to undertake this agenda of remaking their workforce, because most of them will not find the existing skills competencies relevant. At the same time, the supply will not be good enough or large enough to replace the entire workforce, and hence the only option left will be to remake based on the closest proximity of skills.
Jayant, you know, when you were talking about the remake, I was reminded of what one of our portfolio organizations did last June, July, August. You know, it is into financial services, and as all of us know, everybody working remotely, they had a large field sales force. And what they realized was that, people had not stopped buying financial products. It's just that their sales force was not going into the field and selling those products. So what they actually did was pivoted their entire field sales force and, you know, trained them, or rather reskilled them into being and doing telesales, which none of them were doing until then. But the need of the hour was to reach out to the customers through telesales. And they said, okay, why hire new people? We already have a massive field sales force. So they understand selling. They haven't sold it on teles or telephones. So let's train them on that. So they actually did a massive reskilling exercise, which I think is very similar to the remake point which you talked about.
I think I would say build, buy, or rent. I think it's gig economy. I think today's generation is very different. So it's sure. About rent a car, rent a house, Zomato, Swiggy. You know, everything is sharp, quick. I think it's a hybrid model.
I would be sure. One of the notaries for build. And why do I say that is because, you know, we are moving from products to services, to solutions, to experiences. And providing a rich experience requires an understanding of culture. So buying, while it's an option, you know, the learning curve is pretty steep to understand the DNA of the organization. Hence, my proposition is building is a better option. And I agree with Jayant, for building also, hiring right is key.
What works, pull versus push, when it comes to the to validity or success of these interventions, in your experience?
So what I have experienced in my learning during the career, that the pull works more than the push. Because if you see through the basic instinct of the human being, even a child, when he starts walking, so a small child falls several times, breaks his knees, but he wants to walk. Similarly, we have to create that instinct in the organization that if you are going to learn, it is for you. Organization can facilitate.
I would say it's a bit of a combination of both. And if we don't have both, you know, it's like a, like we said, the child wanting, you know, a new thing and falling. But if you don't push the child towards different things, you'd never know what the child is good at. So you try to understand what kind of skill sets, and you know, things keep changing as we move to a different set. I mean, if you are, say, you know, you're at a particular stage and you want to retire, you want to understand how will I be gainfully employed without probably earning money. So therefore, then right. That becomes a push for you. So it keeps changing, and the connotation changes at what point in life you are in and what stage the organization is at. What is the culture of the organization?
When purpose is aligned, then it becomes a pull. If it is not, then it has to be a push. The other thing is people learn differently. Not all will learn only in classroom. Some learn through doing. So are we sensitive? How do we kind of excite them from what excites them? What really they're interested in? I think that's where in the push and pull. Sometimes we are kind of asking them to learn in a classroom, but they like to learn by doing.
With that, thank you very much for all the questions from the audiences. And thank you very much, panelists, once again, for such valuable insights. Personally, learned a lot listening to you, all of you. And over to you, the organizers. Thank you.